Okay, we're back. Mark Farrar, Not Square Design, and I'm on a wrong lesson plan, but here we go. So this is my contact info. Hit pause if you need to grab that. All lessons in this set are related, that are related to AutoCAD are compatible with AutoCAD Lite, as they are in 2D. The design does incorporate a 3D model created in Chief Architect. Won't be part of this plan, this lesson, but at some point we will be touching that, such as lesson 3. And so if you're not interested in anything but AutoCAD, skip lesson 3. So the Peck Residence that we're going to work on has 3 levels. So today it's about setting up X-Refs for multiple levels without getting a circular reference, understanding all the settings, understanding how to do X-clipping, that sort of stuff. So beginner level stuff, with the exception of some intermediate, some people might think it's advanced, but just understanding really how X-Refs work. And a special little trick I recently learned about renaming X-Refs without detaching them. So I'll show that little trick too. So what we get is we want to have a good understanding of this. So since it has 3 levels, we're going to tie all 3 together. Get a good understanding of the external reference setting to make sure we do not get circular references when level 1 reference references both level 0 and level 2, while level 2 references level 1, and so on for all 3 levels. And then at the end of the lesson, you don't have to stick in if you don't want to know this, but I'm just going to do on level 2, it's not the uppermost, it is the main level. I'm also going to show how to attach the PDF file. Maybe I should do the upper level so you can see how screwed up this roof was that came from this source. But boy, buying plans off the internet, not recommended. I probably have so far saved them close to $2 million in build costs. So there's some problems with that. And there's an article I wrote, and on previous lesson I kind of covered that a little bit. Real quick shot. If you want to know more about that, there you go. And there's the wording. You can see if you want to freeze and look at that. But I'm going to click over to my steps because this gets a little mixed up and I get a little mixed up. So what I've done to start is I have opened up my 3 old named plans. And because I do use extensively Chief Architect to do my 3D modeling, material takeoffs, and actually show each wall in an elevation view, the framing that's inside their dimension. So it's kind of like an erector set when I get a plan set up. There is a garage set of final plans that I did just to show off this ability in a really simple form. That's easily understood. So it's just a detached garage that's on my website. If you just type in garage in the search, you'll find it. And it's a complete set of garage plans. It's called something like that. So what we've got is when I open these, I did get this warning. So there's references that are not found. So when I open the external reference, 4.2 upper level floor plan is not found. And it's because it has the word start after it. Now, so we're going to show how to fix all that stuff, but the first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to show you one, I like my stuff in order, so I'm going to move these 4.0, 4.1, 4.2, and then I'm going to show you one, rename, to make it be the same naming convention that I have in Chief Architect, and this is it. I've already gone through this. And so all I really got to do at this point is click on the start, but I think I may have saved a couple times. So I'm going to actually redo them all again by just clicking on the name that I want. So basement level is going to be the level 0 floor plan, and just hit save. And then it says, do you want to replace it? Yes, because I want to get rid of all the stuff I might have changed there, so we can go through it together. Now I'm going to do it for the rest of them, so for the moment, I'm going to pause. Okay, so that being done, I did have this one just to be different. I left the start out so we make sure that we go through that thing of renaming. So let's just start with level 0, and let's go check over to our X-Refs. And here I've got the old one, which was the main level floor plan. And in this case, I'm going to do detach. And that's just because for brand new beginner, I want you to see how to do a full attachment. So I'm going to back out a little bit so we can see it. These are X-Ref lines I use for dimensioning. So don't worry about those too much. But what I want to do first off is I have got filters in my layer sets. So I'm set to my X-Ref layers by just clicking on that guy. And now when I put my layers down to switch layers, all I have are these. And so when I want to bring in the main level, which is level 1, then I want to switch to my level 1. But if you look here, I don't have anything that's named correct. And since I did this save as off of that beginner plan, all my stuff that I was getting, that I corrected off my template, is not here, which is this layer. So real quick, what I'm going to do, I'm going to open this. I'm going to go and just click on blocks because I don't have a direct path there. And if I back up one, I can go to my templates evolving. Evolving just means it's stuff I'm changing and working on. This has a lot more corrected descriptions, all these descriptions out here. I haven't gone through them all, but I did take the time to make sure I went through the X-Ref layers to make sure they were named correctly. And the good beginner set of X-Refs are here, including some that you don't need for this project. But for now, we're going to leave them there. We'll get rid of them somewhere down the line, but I want to keep this lesson decently short. So I'm going to do a Control-Shift-C so I can copy from one drawing to another. I'm going to go 0, comma, oops, that was a period, comma, 0, and then I'm going to hit Enter. So that set my base point at 0, comma, 0. So now when I come in to this first one, I can paste that, Control-V, and tell it the same thing, 0, comma, 0, Enter, and it dropped it there. What that did is look at all these X-Refs it brought in. So there's ones I don't need anymore, these SN out, all that sort of stuff. I just don't need them anymore. So if I go to my layer property manager, I can say, okay, well, I don't use any of these ML deals. I'm just going to use the level 012. So now that I brought in my new ones, which is a really quick way of doing it, is just have a template out there, drop that template in, and all your layers come with it. I'm going to delete those layers. Boom. They all went away. If there had been something on them, which is why I have this, you cannot accidentally delete these layers because they are actually being used. So if I tried to delete another one, so I'll go to my layer manager and let's just pick this one and delete. Oops, sorry. Can't do it. So now that I've got that set, we want to bring in that main level. So we're going to go to my CDs, which is construction documents, level 1. I want it to be X-Ref to the correct level that it's for. And now I'm going to, since you may not have flyouts like this, and we do have unreconciled layers because I brought all these in, and they haven't been reconciled yet. So there's a couple things here. But first, let's view them. These are the unreconciled. And there's a couple new things in here besides the X-Refs that I brought in. Now I'm going to reconcile by right-clicking and choosing Reconcile. Now here's the deal with that. Make sure that your vis retain setting is 1. That's 0. It will, every time you unload, and you're going to learn what unload versus detach is, but every time you unload and reload, you're going to have to reconcile your layers if that's 0. So set it to 1. And now you will have to reconcile your layers only when you bring in new ones. So, that being said, we should now do a Typex ref, or I can click this button if you have this fly out set up. But for beginners, we're just going to X, and it's usually right in here. But I've been doing this so long, I just go REF because it's just the nature of being an old schooler. And then I'm going to attach this drawing and probably pause here again. So we're going to attach level 1 start, which if you look behind is this guy right here. So level 1 start open, and I want it to be an overlay. And the reason I want it to be an overlay is, especially on this level, not so much on this level, on the next level above. So let's go through that when we attach to level 1, because that's going to be where it's most important. But I still want it to be an overlay, and I want the path to be relative, and this can matter. It matters on all of them. So no path will work for what we're doing. Relative will work for what we're doing, and I don't know what full path is for, because there's got to be a reason that you'd want to really lock your path in, but I can never think of why that would happen. What it does is it's exact. So if I created all this stuff in my C drive and I tell it full path, and then I back it up to my external D drive, and then I go to open it, it's not going to see any of the references because it has D colon on and on. In my case, they go to the cloud, or I'm going to email them off to you to use as practice. So I want them to be relative. If they're relative, they need to just be in the same folder, and they'll work just fine. And I use relative also because in there's a special sheet that we'll get into further down the road called the plotting sheet. And in there, there's referenced folders with details, images, all sorts of stuff that are kept in those folders. And so if there's folders that you're referencing, you want relative. If you do no path, it has to be just in the right folder, but you can't have a subfolder. So relative it is, and I hit OK. And I could use the insertion point, but if I do 000, I know that this is set up that way. So it's going to hit the right spot. I got a couple little quick things I need to do to it. One is just select it, and you'll know you got it, because if you didn't, you're going to get a line. But if you got it, you're going to get the whole extra. And the first thing I'm going to do is, it's got all this stuff out here, so I'm going to make that smaller. So I'm going to do X clip, which is XC. Here's your X clip. I want it to be a new boundary. I also want it to be rectangular, so I'm just hitting space. And then I'm going to draw what I want. I can't tell you why when I hit in for the first time, it scrolls out. I can also see my two arrows here that we rotated this house a while back. One of my sheets is wrong. So, great way to check stuff on here. And so it's by seeing one over the other. So now, do you see all that stuff disappear? There's that arrow. This just got much smaller, and if I look at it, there it is. Now let's say I wanted to tighten it down over here. I don't know why I would, but in some cases you will. So if you want to tighten down, you can move these. If you accidentally cut off too much, you can bring it back. I usually bring it back too far and then pull it back in. If I want to see my notes, I'll leave those there, that kind of thing. So now that I've got that X clipped, I want to grab it, and then I need to go to home. Make sure you do this step before you lock it. Modify and send it to back. Now it's behind my actual. actual drawing layers that I'm working on this particular plan. I also noticed there's an angular wall in my basement. I'm going to come back and fix that later so you can see the power of X-ray if you're not familiar. Now that that is behind my actual layer, the last step to this is to come in, and if you just click on, well, here, let's make sure, grab it, and you click on this, it's going to be a layer you're selecting, even if you're not on it. I just happen to have been on it. So this will show you what you've got selected. You can lock it, and when I click out of it and hit escape, you're going to notice it fades. Now, why did it fade? So it's all faded through here. I really see what I'm working on. The reason it's faded out is because under this layers pull down, I've got my fading set to my little magic number of 67. Stick with me for a while, you'll find out what that's all about. But that's the first one, and I will be actually going through the other ones with you. We did bring in a new drawing, so we have to reconcile our layers again, but we don't have to reset Viz Retain. So this is just Control A, select all, right click, reconcile, and then you don't want to still see all these because they will stay there if you have it on all, which is kind of the stock deal. So you want these filters, they come with the drawing. So that's a great place to pause for the moment, and I will be back. So we have done this sheet. Looks like we have the starts in here. Level 2, no reasons to do that to the basement. So we'll do level 2 to this one. And we'll go up and down. So this is where you worry about your circular reference is right now. Because this sheet, this sheet is referencing this one. And I'm about to make this one reference this one. So that's where it really becomes important that you have that. In my drawings, you'll sometimes find these. You can delete them if you want. I already deleted the layers out, so if you purge in here, you're going to kill off the layer set. Down here, I can see I've got an X-ray issue, and that's because it's looking for that guy. It doesn't exist anymore. But let's put the upper level back in by just saying selecting path. Point it to that upper level, so that's going to be level 2. Just do the floor plan 1, open, and boom, it's there. Now, is it on? Yep. And it's not X-clipped, because I see this stuff out here. So I'm going to do XC, and I want it to be a new boundary, I want it to be rectangular, and then I'll just draw it. Now, this is the upper level, so those notes aren't on the upper level, although those sector cuts are, but nah, if you keep them there, you do. If you don't keep them there, yeah, don't. So, I'm on the main level, so if I come down here, I can certainly see where the upper level is, because it's labeled. So I can pick that, do the same thing, make sure you go home right away, because you'll forget this, and then you want to put it in the back before you lock it. Now grab it again, come here, and lock it to fade it. Now, here's the trick to playing with this game. You come over here, look at your external reference. Here it is. I'm going to double-click this guy. This is the new trick. This is more of an advanced move. And type in the word start. And now, it's actually referencing the one that says start by name as well. So, I can see it. Look at that though. I've got the old upper level floor plan. So this needs to read level 2. Floor plan start. Now it matches what this would be once I do a save as and give it that name. So that thing's good to go. Now, what you can do here is right click on this. You got a bunch of options aside from what we've used so far. This is like if you want to replace multiple XREFs and just give them all a new path at once. That's what this is for. From my experience, I haven't found a way to actually change up the drawing itself by bulk. So it's a path. This is all about a path. So the other thing you can do, though, that you will do, and this is where it's kind of like, why did they put them right next to each other? Because when you hit detach, it will detach that drawing. And you can't control Z to get it back. I don't know why that doesn't work. But what I say is just come down, be careful, hit unload. Oh, I missed. Maybe I can't unload it unless, well, it's locked. Unload. Yep, I can't. Oh, it's even telling me. I look at these. Command line's awesome. If you're new, get used to looking at this thing. No matching XREFs found. I wonder if it's because it still says this. This doesn't have the start in it. Let's find that out together. This whole new change the name double click thing, I just discovered. So I wouldn't say I know it entirely yet. So now let's try unload. No matching XREFs found. So let's check its path. Maybe I wasn't looking. I think probably more likely a path problem. And I wasn't going to lesson 2, which I am. So I'm in Peck CDs, lesson 2. And that is the upper level. So that's level 2. That's it. Open. So let's unlock it. Let's find out what's going on. Get some properties in it. Can't really do much to get properties and stuff while it's locked. Okay. The layer properties. I'm going to set my filter. I don't have to look at all these. Let's really make it the layer that we're currently working with. So this will be CD's level 2. Oh, double click. Got my green check, so that's my current layer. Unlock it, and let's see what's going on. So that's it. And if I come down to properties, there's some information here. And to really see this information, you got to stretch this out. It's not giving me the full path, but save path, it's looking for this. Floor plan drawing without. It's looking for that right there. Why can I not unload it? Was it because it was locked? So let's go back to the layer. And I don't think so, because I unlock it all the time. I really don't think that had to do with it. But let's find out. So, now I'll come back into it. I will lock it. And now I should be able to come in here and reload it, no problem. Reload. Boom. There it is. Unload. There it goes. Okay. I don't know what was holding it up. I didn't do anything different. So I got my upper loader. And this may be seem like I'm being repetitive, but this is kind of the... We're kind of learning a little bit together here. Well, actually learning nothing. I don't know what was wrong. So, I do know this is wrong. That I need to rotate to match the plan. But that's a matter of turning that back on and seeing where it is, pulling it over there, matching it to it, that kind of thing. That's kind of what... Well, let's do that. Let's show you what some of the use of this is. So, if I come over here and I reload it, and I come down, let's grab it. And is this the one? Oh, it's locked. Now I can't change the XREF size while it's locked. So I unlock it. Now I can grab that little guy. Grab this one. So I get too close to the other stuff. And at this point, I don't see. So it might be the other drawing, and we're about to attach that. I'm going to check it. see if it had the other north arrow. Then I need to copy it to this sheet. So you can check things real quick by doing that. So I'm gonna go back in here. Let's just prove this, that yes, I can lock it, have it as a locked layer, and then I can also unload it, reload it, and not worry about it. So now I've got this already set to my level zero, my basement. So I'm gonna come in and I can do my flyout if you had that, or we can type XREF again, bring that in, attach, and now I want my basement one, I want the start. I'm gonna say open, and then everything's kind of set up. Let's do something a little different here. Let's do the specify on the screen just to show you what that is. I don't wanna do scale because that really kind of messes with things. And I can show you how to scale things up, but we're gonna do that at the very end with a PDF. For those who already know how to do it, and they'll have to chill out with this. So now I know that this thing was made so that these stick together, and I can see my north arrow at the 45 was with this drawing. So I need to put one on the other drawing, and then I need this one. So if I grab this, I should just grab the object, because it is the object on the current drawing. Here, let's do this properly. So let's make sure we don't forget. Come in here, go home, and modify, send it to the back, grab it again, and lock it. Now it's locked. Locked, so it should fade, and I can tell for sure what is what. So I want to take this guy. I'm going to use the align command, AL. Love the align command. And I'm going to come in close, and pick the point of it. And I want to align that to the point of this. And then I want to take the tail of it. And I want to align that to the tail of this. Boom. There we go. Beautiful north arrow. That's now correct. So I can hit save. And look at that. Unreconciled layers. I have those because I just brought in a brand new drawing. Control A, right click, reconcile. While we're in here, let's check. Viz retain. And it's one. So we are good there. So this is in the background of the other drawing. So I could X-clip that. In order to X-clip it, I need to unlock it. I know this is repetitive. There's some of you know how to do this, but it's one of those things that I do think people should know. So I just hit enter, because the default settings, they're fine. And then I want to keep my arrow finger in the picture. I want to keep the name of it in the picture. And that way I know what layer I'm on at all times. And I like having my zero point at least partially in here. See how I cut the doors out of that? Do they look like they're on this layer? Yes, because they're not yet locked to fade them. So, now they are. You can tell they're not in this drawing. Now I'm in my basement in here. And I can see we got a problem in the basement. We need to fix it. So back here we'll do that. So now I've got this last one, and when I see these sheets, I usually just zoom extend, so next time I see it, it's closer. So here, are there any abnormalities? Let's just check. If there's not, I guess this one is not attached at all, and let's not do the 0, 0. Let's do as if you weren't organized. You didn't have all your stuff the way you wanted. I'm on zero layer. First, let's get to the right layer. So let's go to our layer properties. Let's filter it down. Let's go, we're going to add a main layer to this layer. I'm going to make it current. And then I'm going to come in here and I'm going to XREF to attach. I'm going to pick what I want. I'm going to go up and I want the main layer level 1 start. Open. And I'm going to pretend that this doesn't exist. And then when I specify on screen, I don't have that circle. I don't have that. Okay, so I come in and I go, that looks pretty good. And then I go, you know what, if I keep it off a little bit, you can actually see my baseline. As you get to know my drawings, you'll start to understand what this baseline is and why it's so important. So let's say I get it close. Now I can come in and I can say move, and I'm going to pick my baseline. I want to move this XREF from here to my other baseline. That white line, all it matches these white lines. And now that's lined up. Look at that. Now that's an oddity. Oh, okay, so this didn't work because this corner doesn't exist upstairs. There's a couple things that you can do to fix that. This is the outside of it. Just knowing the plan, this is the outside of the fireplace. You could pick an interior element, more risky. This is pretty complex. If there was an error, I wouldn't want to be having that be the cause of why I can't do it. So I'm going to choose this as a fairly safe point because I know the drawing. You'll know your own drawings. What's a safe point? Oh, that's not what I want. I want to move this from there to there. And what you saw earlier was the fact that, look at that, that's still not hitting it. Because my upper layer is drawn back. Okay. This one is valid. Seems too far. Because this guy there, let's try it. Move. That's my XREF. That to here. And there's a lot of things floating space on this design. So I want to check this at a corner. And look at that. See, I trust areas like this more than I do that front room because there's been so much work I've had to do trying to get that right. And, boy, I look at this, though, and, oh, look at the shift right there. So, that's not the right place. So let's move this straight out. So all I've got now is moving this from here. There we go. I grabbed it. Got it. Now let's go check over here. Now I'm hitting this corner. That corner for that is hitting my white line here. And that makes me comfortable. So this is the siding above. You can see here. Upper siding layer. This is the lower siding layer that's below the wainscot of stone. So this is like the stone veneer that's out there. This is the siding. If I wanted to match my chief, I could move this in half an inch. So when I bring my chief drawing in, they will match perfectly to the outside line, or I can ignore it and look at the other layers because they're already matched up. The siding is kind of not a fixed thing. But it's a lap siding, so it's going to go in and out. And this is where you're going to find, okay, I got some things I need to work on. You know, why is that there and not over there? Which one's correct? And I do know that I'm going to do some work here because I can cover this room above or below this knockout. Because this pops out on the lower level, but it comes in on the upper level. And so the roof has to be a little corner roof down here to cover that. Or the roof from the main porch has to come back to a point out here where I'm going to get the good tie-in and not be hitting into nothing. Because you really can't land on this stuff. This is insulation from that yellow line to this green line. But at any rate, we're in good shape, I feel, as far as do I have alignment. One of these is wrong. I did a lot of work on getting the sitting room straightened out, so one of my levels I just haven't corrected yet, so that I will fix. Here's where the deck used to be. That's where it was in the original drawing, so it was so far back. And then you add the rock onto it, It was just a snake room. So, I've got stair issues. These will match up. And all that stuff's in chief. It's in my 3D plan. Because I've verified that my stairs all line up work in 3D. So that's a matter of importance for later lesson for people who want to know the 3D stuff. So what I did, kind of promise on this thing, let's hit save. Got my unreconciled, so let's reconcile these. Control A, go in, reconcile the layers, put on my own on extra. Now, non-extra, so let's get out to, I like to work a lot on my G-Jungle, unless I'm doing something particular, and I'll switch layers. So I'll just set it there while I'm doing nothing. So like these, you know. My layer properties manager, again, I want it to be here, out on all, infinitely long if it's on all, and then I can narrow it down if I want. And I need to create a filter for that guy, but that's a whole different lesson too. I'm trying to keep this down inside. So let's go there, go to the model, and let's also change its that layer set looks good. So here, I just need to hit G, switch that to current, do the same here. It's zoom extents, click G, make that current. Oh, it's frozen. So, frozen layers, those of you who are really new, cannot be made current layers. So, I just come down to G. All right. And double click it while I'm here. Now it's spot and current. So, what we want to do is I'm going to go find the original architectural drawing for this level. That's a PDF. We're going to toss it under here. It's going to come in as like a postage stamp, and we got to get it to the right scale. So we could trace it if we wanted to. So it's not going to fit this newer version because I've done so much change to this plan, but it'll at least show you how to do this procedure. So for those of you who are done with learning the XREF stuff, I am finished with that part, and now I'm going to do the attachment of a PDF. I'm going to pause and get that information. Okay, so I found it. So now, are you hanging in there? We are at the 37-minute mark. Went through that pretty thoroughly, though, so you should understand your XREFs good. We are going to go to an appropriate XREF layer for an image. So here's XREF image. There is an image for the main layer. Now, what I would be curious is this part of my template? But for this plan, this was probably created. And so if I come over to my layer properties, I probably created this so that, see this, it says basement reference layer. And so I can tell you that it's main layer, it says ML. So let's go in here and say delete, delete. One more delete. L, come down here, and space one. So let's take this, and we're going to change it to LBL1. Oops, all caps and dashes. In my layers, the reason I don't do my names, because everybody does everything in all caps and AutoCAD, I don't do names because as I'm going through and updating all my blocks and stuff to the new standards, putting in new energies, new code requirements, all that sort of stuff, I know if I've updated it because it has lowercase letters in the name of the drawing. So that's the reason behind that. Most people stick to an all caps name. So now XREF image of level one, I'm on it, it's active. So now I need to go to a different kind of way of putting it in. We're not doing an XREF, we're putting it in a PDF. So we have to use this attach. It's on your insert tab. And then I have to get to it. So here's my CDs, I'm gonna back out. And I'm looking for PDFs from owner. CS main level floor plan. There's a preview. It is what I'm looking for. I'm going to open it. Insertion point, I want to specify that on screen. And scale, I'm going to kind of get it near where I want. I'm going to say okay. So, as you can see, it's wee small. So, I'm just going to bring it down here for right now. Let's get it kind of aligned with that lower wall-ish. And then, wow, it unfortunately snapped. So, let's escape. I'll show you how to keep that from happening when you really don't want it to. So, let's delete this. And it's just, you can either come down here and quickly turn off your snaps. But there's another way, by just typing in words if it's like a one-use thing. If you're not going to be on snaps for a while, turn them off. But if you just need to do it once, let's go to insert. Oh, this is for blocks. Sorry. I'm going to go to attach. I'm going to pick that again and hit open. And then when I go to pick my point, I'm going to say okay, but I'm going to type the word none so that it snaps to nothing. And now when I come in here, get close to my wall, didn't grab anything. It didn't. So now I want to get it to where I feel like it's going to be somewhat close, but I can't even see the image, so I don't know where that really is. Now that I've gotten somewhat close, I have got a 60-foot measurement. So 12, 34, 56, and 460. Okay, just want to check. It's a little blurry. So I want to do a line. I got my crosshair on here. Pretty good. And then I'm going to come down to here. Get my crosshair on here. Really good. And I've got a nice straight line. See how it's snapping to that straight? I'm going to drop this there. And then I'm going to scale this guy. So I'm going to draw another line by going up here and then over 60. This is the size I want it to go to. Let's change its color, the layer, whatever you want to do. I don't care. Let's pick something at random because it's all going to go away in a minute. Now I'm going to hit scale. SC. What am I scaling? I'm scaling this. And I am scaling it about this point. Doesn't really matter. I'm scaling about this point. And then I want to do a reference. So I can either type R or I can go down here and say reference. My reference, is going to be from here out to that line, but that's at a diagonal. I forgot one little step here. Let's come in. I'm going to put a line down this. Enough to where I can drag straight out and intersect that. Now let's do the scale again. So, SC. I'm going to scale this from here, and I know I'm not on it. It's a relative thing. See, it stretches no matter what. I'm on it or not. So now I type R for reference. I'm going to say I want to reference it from this point to that point out straight until I intersect my yellow line. Click. So if I look at my purple line, that's about as good as you're going to get with a PDF. And now I would just be a matter of moving it into position. So delete it. Unfortunately, it's a little rough to see. Let's don't do that. Let's keep this reference here. Because let's do this as if I was fresh. I'd come in here. I'd say I got my image. And now I can lock it. Unfortunately, when I lock it, it didn't fade. It didn't fade because it's not a reference. So locking it or not locking it. Locking it just keeps it still. Now I do want it to be still, so locking it's fine. Here's how you fade this one. But I can't because it's locked. So I gotta unlock it first. And then when I select it, and then I go to fade it. I can drag it out to where I feel like it looks good. Because I'm such a weirdo. I just put 67 in here. And there I go. Now, I can lock it. Oops, that wasn't locked. It was close to lock. Lock. That won't move. And now I can come in here. And I love excellent. So, what I would do is switch myself, and I'd be tracing like my outside major wall first. So I want to go to my exterior wall. And one of my objects is on a locked layer and cannot be updated. I don't know what it's trying to do. But that wasn't what I was after updating anything. So XL for an X line or an infinite length line, then horizontal, and start dropping them. There's one there. Here, I'm doing just the outside wall. The inside wall, I'm just going to offset 5.5 feet once I get some practical dimensions. That line up, then I don't have to worry about it. Come in here and start just dropping them all over the place. Then do your XLs vertical. And, you know, I'm not going to get close. Just going to zoom in and out, but it's sort of the same deal. Come in, place them where you see them. On the exterior line, so undo that one. Oh, won't do it. So I can actually delete that one if I want. But that's an exterior wall there. I didn't get it close enough. But all I'm trying to do is show the basics. So then I do chamfer, CH. I'd have my distance set to 0, 0, and 0. And then I can square all these off and start to form what I'm after. If I had a line here, that'd be my next one. Square that off. So I just drop in my X line, square them all off, and then start checking. What's the distance from here to here? Well, it is 39 foot 11 and a half. So I don't want to keep this line and try and get it that half inch because my accuracy is a 16th. So I could end up a 32nd off. I'm a 32nd off on that one and a 32nd off on this one. And then I go dimensioning stuff. And I get these 16ths, it's hard to track them down. So if you got that down as 39, 11 and a half, and just offset 40 feet, enter, and pop that up there, and use that, you know it's going to be 40 feet. If I look out here, and I add these up, I've got a hard to read number, 8 and 5 maybe, so 13. 9 and 6, so 15, so 13, 15, 28, and 12, there you go, 40, there's a number, so now we've got it 40 feet apart, and I just keep going. So that's how you scale these up, use them. If I got to a point where, like, I said, okay, I'm getting this where I want it, everything was looking good, I had this more accurately placed, and then I chamfered this, then I could, if I wanted to, take this and move it. Let's say I had something drawn. Oh, I can't move it with it locked. So I need to go to my, I could type X, and that'll get me way down to the bottom real quick. My image, unlock it. Now it's here and it's usable. I can move it. It's still faded. Even though it's locked, because it's a different function. I want to move it from here to, guess what? I got one right there. Now, where'd my drawing go? It's unlocked. Let's take it, go to home, go to modify, and put it behind your line work. Now you can see your line work. I hope that's helpful. That was the last little tidbit at the end of this. Attaching PDFs, PNGs, just all kinds of image files. They all come in that way. So I hope you all enjoyed this video and learned something new. I did. I've been doing it myself. So we'll keep on going. I've been using this since 1988 when it was AutoCAD 8. I'm still learning stuff. There's a lot of things in this program. So have fun with it, and I can promise you that, here's what I used to tell new people that just started working for me. You're going to be frustrated, and you're going to be frustrated for about 6 weeks, and then it's just going to be like a light switch flipped and it all makes sense. Not part of it. It all makes sense. So be patient at first. Just keep following along. You'll get it. Have a great evening, and I'll see you next time. Mark Farrar with Not Square Design in Butte, Montana.